This is the second presentation of this series. When we examine the optic nerve, you need to identify the neural rim. The outer limit of the neural rim is identified by being inside the scleral ring of Elschnig. If Elschnig's scleral ring is not visible, then we depend on the peripapillary atrophy. On the other hand, the inner limit of the rim, this is the cup, is identified by bending of the blood vessels. Either you can see change of the blood vessel with you have a stereoscopic from this examination, or you can depend on change of the reflection along the vessel. What is the border tissue of Elschnig? It's a connective tissue extending from the sclera to the Bowman's membrane, separating the choroid from the axons of the neurons passing in the optic nerve. As you can see here in this histology, this is the location of the border tissue of Elschnig. The border tissue of Elschnig can be in relation to the sclera, either externally oblique, like in this situation, can be vertical, or can be internally oblique. When it is externally oblique, it will be visible when you are doing fundus examination. In the other situations, we will not see it. In this example, you can see the border tissue of Elschnig on the temporal side here, but it's not visible on the nasal side. What about the peripapillary atrophy? We have what's known as alpha zone and beta zone. Alpha zone is a zone of hyperpigmentation of the retinal pigment epithelium, while beta zone is a zone of irregular pigmentation of the retinal pigment epithelium. Then we have the disc. So this is the normal retinal pigment epithelium. This is the zone of hyperpigmentation. This is the zone of atrophy or depigmentation or irregular pigmentation. Then we have the disc. Here you can see the zone of hyperpigmentation, this is alpha zone, then irregular pigmentation, this is beta zone, then you have here the border tissue of Elschnig. Again, this is the zone of hyperpigmentation, so this is alpha, this is the zone of irregular pigmentation, so this is beta. Just inside the peripapillary atrophy, this is the limit of the neural tissue. On this side, you can see only alpha zone. In this example, hyperpigmentation, irregular pigmentation, border tissue of Elschnig, then the disc will start from here. What about the cup? We follow the blood vessels, especially the medium-sized blood vessels, and we check any change of the direction of the vessels. As noticed here, you can see the reflection along the vessel. It disappears in this area, so we get a change in the direction at this location. In this example, this is the outer limit of the neural tissue just inside the border tissue of Elschnig, and this is the location of change of blood vessels. This is the limit of the cup. Here the limits of the cup. Sometimes it's not visible all around, but in many areas you can define it certainly. This is the outer limit inside the peripapillary atrophy. So here this is the Elschnig border, and the neural tissue is just inside it. And for the cup, we depend on change direction of the blood vessels. We don't depend on color, we depend on change of direction of the blood vessels. So to sum up, the outer border of the disc margin is defined by being just inside the sclera ring of Elschnig, and if this is not available, not seen, we depend on the peripapillary atrophy. For the cupping, we change of the direction of the blood vessels. Thank you.